Hey, what's up, y'all? Come do my best friend's makeup with me. So I had already started out by laying primer and foundation, so I'm just going in with some concealer. The spots I always focus on are like chin, under the eyes, under the nose, as you can see me working on right now, and then in the forehead. And then I'm gonna go in with my Morphe brush and blend that out here. And there we go, a little tap, tap, tap action. So we're just blending that out. I'm pretty sure I used the Maybelline Fit Me foundation or concealer for that. And then for under the eyes, I just use a beauty blender rather than a brush. In the areas that I want the foundation or the concealer to stay pretty much in place, I'll use a brush and tap it in. Regardless, I'm tapping it in, but I feel like when I'm working on like the in between the eyebrows, it's a little more precise versus under the eyes. I can use a beauty blender. So now I'm just filling in her eyebrows. She already has very defined eyebrows, so I'm just giving it a little extra color, making sure everything's even. And then I am taking, I was filling in the other one. So now we are just laying some concealer on the eyes as a primer, and I also clean up the brows with concealer as well with a Morphe brush, and I just go along the brow line just to clean that up. And if you ever made any mistakes, you can't notice because you just cleaned it up. So now I'm blending that concealer on her eyes. Now I'm just gonna add some shadow and darken her crease a little, give some color and dimension to it. And again, I'm just darkening that crease. We're going for a nice cut crease. Again, we're 2016 girlies out here. So I'm going for a nice little cut crease moment and darkening that up. I really like to hold my brushes down towards the middle or the end so that I get a lighter effect. When you hold the brush a little bit lighter or further away, it's not as much product on right off the bat, and it's so much easier to go lighter and add more than to go heavier and take off, you know what I mean? So I always hold my stuff towards the end, and it just helps control how much is actually getting on. So now that cut crease is forming, I just packed some concealer on her eyelids. And I'm doing that cut crease right there. You can see where I worked it in. Again, I'm just using that Maybelline Fit Me concealer and really packing that on there. I'm pretty sure I used like the lightest shade they have, like number one or something like that. So I really want like a white base basically, so that that pigment that I'm gonna pack right on top of the concealer really looks good and pops. Now I am just packing a light shade on top of that concealer to really get it to set into place on her eyelid, trying to get it to not move, not budge, and keep it in place all day long. And that is the palette I'm using. It's the Urban Decay Wild West one, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure I was using just the colors in that one, like the, I think there's a beige one in it. I'm not sure. I don't have it in front of me right now. Here we are reevaluating our lives and our choices. So I went ahead and did her eyeliner and her wings off camera, but this is the look. And now I'm just adding a little lipstick on there. I did add sparkles to the lid. We went for this little gold shimmery moment because the other shadow is like a pink. So I'm doing a nude lip. I really like when you have a big pop in the eyes to have minimal on the lips, or vice versa. So you have a big pop in the lips and you have lighter neutral eyes. So that's kind of the vibe I was going for. We went for the bold eye, so I went with the nude-ish lipstick. Now I'm adding the Michaela lip gloss in the gold shimmery. Since we did a gold eye, I figured the gold sparkly lip gloss moment would be so cute. Here she is checking the results in the camera, and here is the final look. I'm so excited with how this turned out. She absolutely loved it. So lovely. And thank you guys for watching.